Hello YouTube, this is Bad Halo Forging, and today I'm just going to be giving you a few tips on making your maps, and, you know, how you should make them, what you should think about when making them, and all that good stuff. Let's get into it. First thing I want to say is I will try to start uploading about 3 times a week, once on the weekend, maybe once on Tuesday, and once on Thursday or Friday. So expect kind of that schedule depending on when I get to upload. But let's actually get into the video now. The first tip I have for you is to draw out your maps. The reason for this is to help you make your map as you'll be going off of a plan instead of trying to freeball it. And it'll also let you see your map on the paper before you even make it. So you can see, hey, is this map going to be balanced for each team if you're making an asymmetrical map? Or, hey, is there enough paths for the players to go through? Just stuff like that. The second tip I have for you is to make a basic form of your map first. And what I mean by that is just making your map without any aesthetics made onto it, like bushes, rocks, stuff like that. This is so that way you can see if there's any problems, and if you are able to playtest it with some friends, you can easily fix it. Whereas if you would have, you know, made it look pretty, you might have to delete all that stuff that you did to it. It just makes it much easier to make it basic for. The third tip I have for you is to use power weapons to control the flow of your map. And what I mean by this is players will typically go towards the power weapons. Because that's what Halo is about, you know? Getting those power weapons, killing lots of people, having fun. And let's say, for example, you're playing on your map that you made with some friends. And you want everybody to go to the middle because that's like where you designed most of your map around, but they go somewhere else for some reason. The way you could fix this is by adding a rocket launcher or some form of power weapon to the middle. Because this will cause players to want to go to the middle and try and get the power weapon and fight over it. Just stuff like that you can do with it. So this last tip I have for you is to balance your weapons out. And this is important because if you don't balance them out, especially on asymmetrical maps, and one team gets the advantage, it's gonna go down terribly. And as you can see, this is a Blow Up the Bridge map, and you can definitely tell which weapons are overpowered. For example, the Berserker's Claw completely destroys the bridge and has a lot of ammo, so you wouldn't want that on a map. This weapon right here does destroy the bridge, but it only has a little bit of ammo, and it's really hard to reload, so it's fairly balanced. There's a few ways you can balance weapons. One, you could just not have them and only have weaker weapons, which is what I would do most of the time. Or you could make the better weapons have less ammo or some other sort of disadvantage. Like this. This is a special weapon, if you can tell where you make it. And as you can see, it reloads one bullet at a time. So that way, it isn't too strong. But yeah, that's it. Thanks for watching. I'm just have a few more things to say, and the video will be over. And to end the video off, I want to ask, what do you guys want to see next? Do you want to see more Forge tutorials? Would you like to see me doing like a Forge session in a video or two? Would you like to see me show off some custom games? Do more videos like these? Remake some custom games like a Jump Rope? Talk about or just ramble about Forge? Let me know in the comments what you want to see. Thanks for watching.